It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Saturday evening from this part of the world. And I've really been thinking, I've been thinking about the single brothers and the single sisters. And I have a question for you. But before I go on to my question, if you're new here, you're welcome to this family. And please consider subscribing before you go. And don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that you can get notified anytime we drop new videos. There's so many goodies. You can go onto our playlist and check out all our videos. And so many great content are coming on the way. Back to my point for today. Sincerely speaking, a lot of thought have been coming to my mind on the single brothers and sisters. And I have a question for you today. What exactly are you looking for? From that beautiful lady and from that handsome looking guy, what do you want? What exactly are you looking for? Take a moment. Before you answer this question, I want you to watch this video. It's going to be of great help. And ensure that you answer this question. But don't forget, you have to ask yourself and answer that question to yourself. What am I looking for? Watch this.
In 600 meters, take the ramp to East Industrial Street.
Hi everyone, this is Nkoye from The Vision Guide. And how are you all doing today? We are out in the park and I thought, okay, let me just make a video. And I asked my husband to sit down. He doesn't know anything that I'm about to say. He has no idea. I just asked him to sit down and I want to make a video. So let's get started and let's see what this video is all about. Once again, thank you for always coming back. Thank you for your comment. Don't forget, we really appreciate your comment. Please, after watching this video, drop your comment. We would like to get your view. Don't forget to click the bell button in case you have not done so, so that you get notified anytime we drop new video. Okay, let's get started. This is my husband. You met him before. So I'll just be asking him a few questions and I hope he's going to give me the answer I want to get. All right. Anyways, we met back in the university days. And then I just want to ask you, the moment you saw me, what came to your mind? What was it? What did you see that very moment you saw me for the first time? We graduated from the same university. Same department, but different level year. I was in my third year in the university, and he was in his final year, the fifth year. We studied electrical electronics. So I just want to know, at that moment that you first saw me, that tiny, tiny, teeny, tiny lady, so what came to your mind? What was the thing that was going on in your head?
Thank you for that question. Actually, it's impromptu, but I will try my best. The first time I saw you, actually, you know, I saw beauty. Anyway, that was the first thing. I can't deny that.
I'm blushing now.
Then I saw a lady that can make a better life with me, actually. And I saw a lady with a vision. It's talking to you first, you know, discussing with you and all those things. I know I used to say I saw my better half.
I remember that word very clearly, my better half, because I remember the first time you spoke to me like, okay, you were trying to propose, let me say, like, I want you to be my better half. I'm like, what is better half? What is this guy, you know, what is this guy up to and things like that? Okay, all right, you saw a lady, you said you saw beauty, and yeah. I said, of course, I'm beautiful.
Sure, sure. I'm always.
And the one that struck me the most is the aspect you said you saw vision. So, you know, this aspect really, like, it's a big deal to me. He said he saw me and he saw a vision. It means it's not just about today, you know. Vision is something that you have to nurture, you have to nourish, you have to carry it carefully. So he said he saw me and he saw vision, and that is a great, you know, that is a great reassurance for me.
Yes.
That I have been a lady of vision. So only the vision guide, in case you don't know, that's our slogan.
Yeah.
Only the vision can guide.
Correct.
So tell me, at what point do you think this is the person I'm going to spend the rest of my life with?
I'm not relaxing it.
Instantly. There was no doubt. There was no, like, going back or... There was, let me just do the one simple one. There was no doubt.
Rose.
Seeing you, before meeting you, I knew what the outcome was going to be. No, you didn't know actually, but I knew what the outcome. I saw today before we met. So it's great seeing us together like this today. I saw vision. I saw a woman with a purpose, with a vision, an enthusiastic lady, and a very energetic lady, and a very wise lady.
Thank you, baby. Yeah. Thank you. All right, I know, I just feel like saying some things and stopping the questions, because I feel there's some things I need to tell the single lady out there. He said he saw me, saw vision, very good. But I want you to know that when I saw him, I didn't really see much. But let me clear you. I'm not saying I didn't see a man of purpose. Yes, he was that guy who I met a man who loved God. He still loves God. He's a man who is intelligent. He's very brilliant. Very dedicated. So his life was like a triangle from school to library and church. So I just want to speak to the single ladies out there. Sometimes what you're going to see is not going to look exactly like your dream or the vision you have. But don't forget, I said this guy right here is following God and I'm following him. Then his lifestyle then was just a triangle from school to the library back to church. So of course, at that moment I'm born again, I was born again, but my own lifestyle is I believe in the social. I don't go to club. I never been to club before. However, you know, I was like, I hope this brother is, I hope he's serious. What is he up to? Can't he just see? What are you looking for? At least go to the other sisters, not me, you know. And I was like, no way. Is this guy serious and doing like that? But what am I trying to say? Single ladies, listen to this. What you're going to see, the brother that might come your way that God has designed for you or prepared for you, might not exactly be what you have envisioned. So, but the most important thing is the person who loves God is following God, and you know his relationship with God is genuine, and you now go back to God and pray about it. And if God says yes, who are you to say no? I'm telling you, sisters, if I come back to this life again, which I'm not even planning to come back, as long as he's coming back, I'm coming back with him. I can marry him over and over again. And we're talking about, the whole thing is talking about enjoying your home and enjoying your marriage as God ordained it. Original plan of God for homes. Like, let your home, we are enjoying our home as heaven on earth. And everyone can actually experience this if only you trust God, if only you put Jesus at the center of it all. All right, Fekilia, you're welcome to the show. All right, okay. I made a video about 4 years ago about you having a dream, you putting down what you want in a man, the kind of man you want, six packs, you want pocket filled, you want a PhD holder, a master's degree holder, a professor. These things are wonderful. Don't get me wrong. They are marvelous. They are excellent. However, it is not the final thing. What is God saying? What is that man that God has prepared for you? I am going to make another video about this, saying you that you have that list. What are you doing about your own list? The Bible was talking about Proverbs 31 woman. But these days, the ladies has turned into Proverbs 31 men. They're just sitting and relaxing. However, that is not our point today. Our point today is about letting God be the foundation. Allowing God to be the foundation of the home. Holding God on his word and just ensure that the vision is clear. There's a lot of things that when we came together, we moved on vision. Like, we having twins, don't forget, you know, for those of you who has been on this channel, know that we have a set of twins by the grace of God, and these babies came after 6 years, 1 month and 13 days of we've been married. We waited for them for 6 years, 1 month and 13 days. So through it all, what was our strength? It was the word of the Lord that says to us at the beginning of our marriage that this is my home. This is my home. So we were not worried. We were just busy. We were just busy with God's business. Only two that have the same vision, only two that has agreed and following God can achieve this. So to single brothers out there, single sisters out there, before you take any decision in marriage, ensure that you both have the same vision and using Christ Jesus, if you believe in him, and using him as a foundation of your home. It is very important. If Jesus is in the boat will shake, but it will not capsize. And that is a simple way. People ask, how do you enjoy your marriage? How do you do it? I say you've never been in any argument before or quarrel. Because we allowed God. When you allowed God, you see, a lot of people are just, they don't know what they're missing if God is not in their life. If God is not in your marriage, you can't do it by your brain. You can't calculate it with your wisdom. So, brother, stop looking for that figure eight. It's not bad to have figure eight. I am beautiful and my husband is blessed. These things are wonderful. Sisters, you know, six pack is good, but six pack will not make you a good husband. I'm telling you, six packs, if that is the only thing you're looking for in a man, it will not last. It doesn't worth it. So what are you looking unto? The Bible says we look unto Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. So in all, looking unto Jesus for your life partner. Like, you know, we don't want this video to be long. There is a lot of things we met together, and the vision of God carry us through. It was the vision of God when we met. You know, when you have somebody that you have the same that you have the same vision, life becomes easier. Like for me personally, I knew God already said I was going to have twins. No prophet told me. God said to me, and I believe it. That was around the year 2000. We met in 2006, right, darling?
Yes, correct.
I knew that from the year 2000 I was going to have a set of twins, and I know their name is going to be Peculiar and Precious. I met my sweet darling husband in 2006. So when we met, I carried on this vision and I said, this is what I believe God said about me. And he embraced it. That can only happen if God is involved. So single sister, single brother, what are you looking for? You are looking for that guy with a vision. You are looking for that lady with a vision. If two vision comes together and you lay the foundation, it's going to be a solid rock. And don't forget that Jesus Christ is a solid rock. You understand what I'm saying? So when I told him, he embraced the vision. We believed God together. We met in 2006. And 2009, we got married. 2009, 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013. Okay, if not for God, you know, he would have asked me, you said God said this to you. Where are the babies? But that was never our conversation. We never looked back. We never discussed one day that God, you said, but you told me God said, now we are now arguing. Correct. So where is the baby? Oh, I need it. No, it never happened. We were just rejoicing. We know they will come. If we want to be down, we know that God, no, we just get busy. It's when you are not busy with God's business, that's why the devil can feed you with words or something like that. So as you get into that relationship, as you start that home, as you start that godly marriage, it is very important for you to have a word from the Lord, right? So we're going to be talking about a lot more of things later. So ladies, don't forget Esau vision and also Esau beauty. I pray for my ladies. I have a lot of single ladies that I'm trusting God for a life partner, for the perfect man. I have a lot of single brothers that I'm trusting God for a life partner, the perfect sister. Mm. However, the vision must guide. I'm praying for them that they have a lady and a man who is spirit-filled and pocket-filled and beauty and handsomeness, everything full package, because you have waited. Our prayer for you tonight is the Lord is going to give you that total package that you desire. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for watching to the end. Don't forget, we are from the Vision Guide and we are in Koye. This name was given to us right in the university days by some of our friends, because yeah, it's Yinka and Oye. So it becomes Inkoye. Thank you for watching Inkoye on the Vision Guide. PMP, actually you're not part of this video, but daddy said PMP. All right, Inkoye and PMP. All right, so please, if you have not subscribed, please don't go without clicking the subscribe button. Don't go without clicking, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell. And also, your comment, I highly appreciate it. Please drop your comment. We love reading your comments. Thank you for your support as always. We love you. We love you. Bye.
Bye.